Hey everyone. Make a brew. Just got here to Camp Bazza. This is that pot. Sean Coffee sent me over from America. I won it in a competition, come second. Perfect on that. That's that combination sorted. There's the old tea bag, Sean. Just while I'm on the subject, I just want to mention about the Coleman 533. My daughter's bought me for my birthday. Anyway, this is the second one. I had to return the first one. Locked up and just won't get going. But the company, Camping Online, absolutely can't fault them. Sent it back and I put in a little note saying I'm coming back camping on Sunday. I think I sent it Wednesday and Saturday morning it come. So the service was second to none. No hassles or nothing, they just did a straight replacement. So thumbs up for Camping Online. If I need any more products, I'll be definitely using it again. The service was second to none, and that's what you want from a company. I've had one of these stove before 15 years and I've still got it somewhere. I think it's in the garage or somewhere. I'll have to try and dig it out. And but the jenny's totally blocked on it, so it just needs a new jenny. But the girls got me this for my birthday, so but the company I got it off brand, superb. Camping Online, first class, no hassle, just changed it and away we went. So spot on. That's a gorgeous day. Gorgeous day. T-shirt weather. Contrast from last year is unreal. I don't think spring started till near end of April. And now we're on the last days of March. And gorgeous. And the light nights are coming now. Clocks have gone forward. So the light nights are beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. Gorgeous. So, doing three nights, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, go back on Wednesday. I love it. Paul's very kind to let me stay here while I'm doing this. Bit of welding, so absolutely. Oh, this one's working proper, perfect. So I'll bring you back in a bit, everyone. Gorgeous, what a beautiful day! Beautiful day. Okay, everyone, I'll bring you back in a bit. Boiling away now. Get our tea bag. Travel some miles this tea bag. All the way from America. Turn her off. Nice little paw that is. Let that stew for a bit. Hi guys and ladies, have a look at this I've made.
for the cast iron set, made it bigger so we can get everything in. It's not finished yet, just got to screw the hinges on the lid. But as soon as they're done, I can get the big, if you have a look at the bottom, the big dutchie, frying pan, small dutchie, stock pot, and the handle. Now if I put the small dutchie down first and then put the big dutchie on top and obviously turn the lid round, I can get the griddle pan, the griddle thing in as well, but because the big dutchie's got a griddle on it, I've left it at home. So okay, so that's the box. Just put a bit of wood at the bottom to stop them clanking into each other. And so there we go. As I say, I've just got to screw the hinges on. Got no small screws, but Paul's got some. So that's that. Okay, so that's the box. It's going to become a table as well. I'll put it inside the tent and use it as a table, come box, sit on it. So okay, that's the box I've made for the Dutch kit. Okay everyone, preparing tea. I'm going to have a bit of chilli, a bit of garlic, onion, some new potatoes, and I've got two pork steaks. So that's what we've got for tea. Chop the onion. Whoops. Bit rickety. You know what, I could live like this. The more I'm up here, I could live like this. When I'm at home, I just think about getting back. That's all I do, really, think about getting back. Big frying pan. As I say, Paul ain't got a clue how much he's helped me. You know, since the death of my wife. I was out last night with a few mates. They took me out for my birthday drink, and I was in this pub. I was talking to someone, and summer just reminded me of a God. There's just floods of tears everywhere. Just a stupid little thing that sets you off. It really is. As I say, I bought the Arctic tent for me and the missus. She's never even seen it. Saw it on the video, but she never even spent a night in it. Bless her.
You know, it's, oh, they very nearly went down the path of hitting the drink and not giving up, but very nearly down that path. But this, getting this bit of welding up here in Lincoln and then using this facility, I think it saved me. It's as if it was all meant to be, or a reason. I mean, we always went in, Paul wanted to buy an axe, and you know, I saw the welding set that I used to use as an apprentice, and next thing, you know, I'm there. But it was like it was all, you know, the more I think of it, the more it was like it was planned, really. Not planned, it can't be planned, but meant to be, as you say. I don't know if any of you are superstitious or think that things happen for a reason or whatever, I don't know. But I think without it, I think I would have gone down another path, really. I think I would have been a quite that's bad, that one, quite different outlook, you know. I'm going to tell you something now. About 6 weeks before Kaz died, she got me in my daughter Lauren at the table, and you know, she was only 39, but she made us promise. She was talking about her death, and she made us promise to look after each other and we'll be all right, and you know, and I thought, Dad, what are you on about? You're 39. We've got tons of life to do, you know. And on the day, well, on the early hours, on the night she died, she broke her shoulder. I don't know if you know, she slipped in the shower. And on the night she died, it was the 2nd of December, she did say to me, go on, I'll let you open. Shouldn't have done that. Shouldn't have done that. And Lee Chili's 1 minute. God, shouldn't have done that. Sorry. Singing. Silly, silly boy. Yeah, she says, open one of your Christmas presents. So, I mean, 1 minute. I'm half crying and half stinging. Yeah, she'll open one of your Christmas presents, Bri. And they opened some Brazil walnuts, chocolate Brazil walnuts. Love them. She gets them me every year. And she used to get me a Terry's chocolate orange every year without fail. So I opened these Brazil nuts. And I don't know, and I'm not saying she knew, but the way she watched me eat them Brazil nuts was, you know, like a mother looking over a newborn baby. You know, it's weird. It is weird. I'll miss you, darling. Do you miss you? My eyes are steaming. cry, bro, how he's been handling chilies. Anyway, I'll be alright in a sec, 1 minute. Anyway, Paul doesn't realise how much this has helped me. Alright, I'm going to stop you there. I'm going to carry on with my tea and I'm going to have a good cry.
So I've just put the port stakes in. I'm sorry about the tears before. I'm alright now. Just had a good one. Got it out of my system. You get days and moments like that. You got to carry on, ain't you? You got to carry on. You know, she'd want me to anyway. Anyway, so there's the stakes. I'm going to do new potatoes, sweet corn, and some nice spicy gravy, what Mark's showing us. Good lad, Mark. Alright, bye. Hi, everyone. So, tea's all done now. Oops, let's straighten this up. Sorry. Tea's all done now, and Paul's not staying. Can't get out. So I've been on my own for 2 nights now. He comes up, we have a bite to eat, and then he's been going home. Bobby, poor Bobby, he doesn't know what to do, the lad. He thinks, shall I get in bed or what? But, I'm a bit red and a bit sweater. Do apologise. It's nice and warm in here. So, yep, as I say, I'm on my tod. And I do apologise for the for getting upset early on in the video, but I'm gonna leave it in because, you know, it's how my life is at the moment. So a bit teary eyed and I get upset, and you know, that's just the way it is. End of. So I'm gonna leave it in, as I said, and you know, it'd be nice to look back, hopefully in a few years when, well, you don't know how your life's going to pan out there, but like I say, it'd be nice to look back. Whatever happens, as I say, just take each day as it comes now, because, God, that was one out of the blue, that. Let me just move my head away from that. That was one out of the blue. So anyway, for tomorrow, back with Ray tomorrow, finish some chisels off, and Paul's coming back for tea tomorrow night, so he's not doing an overnighter on this trip. So this one's Camp Bazza by myself, really. Been alright, been nice. Been a nice chill out and sort the old head out, I think, this trip. As I say, it does help, and it's great of Paul to, you know, to let me use a Camp Bazza, the facilities there for just spending time while I do this work for Ray. So that's about it, really. Same old, we've had tea. Cooked it outside because it was a beautiful day. So, you know, we cooked tea outside, ate it outside, and I'm just lay on my bed now. Show you, I got the fire. I'm not know if you can see. Oh, there's that pot all set up on me, ready for morning. So I've got my brew. There's that, my torch. Got my head torch there, my phone for my alarm. So clicker to for lighting the brew in the morning. Tea bags, cup, and the milk's on the floor. And that's about it. Can you see in the background the wood stove? So that's all on. Nice, really nice and warm and cosy in here. As I say, it's all to myself. Which it's not too bad, really. If I must say myself, it's not too bad at all. Yeah. I do miss my mate Andy and Paul when we're all three of us are in here, we're talking about bushcraft and camping and cooking and eating. Well, basically what we talk about. It's what us lads do, we just rabbit crap really. But we're not doing anyone any harm, and it's our kind of thing we talk about. Mainly about how we could better the camp. As I say, the plans in the summer is to have a permanent cooking station outside. I know we've got the kitchen, but I mean like, gonna look on the internet, get some plans for a proper outside cooking station so we can hang the Dutch oven and cook on a grill, outside griddle and stuff like that. So I'll have a look on then, get it all ordered and the steel or bar ordered and make it up. So that should be all right. That's about it really. The bushcraft show again, looking forward to that. I've not bought my ticket yet, I will do soon. That's a nice result for my mate Andy, Stony Broke. He won some competition he's entered, and he's won a free ticket for the bushcraft show, plus £100 spending money. Good on you, Andy. You know what, I don't think it could have gone to a more deserving person, really can't. So good on you there, Mr. Andy, Stony Broke Bushcraft. A good deserving win for your competition you've entered, so. And good on the lad who's put the gift up. That's a cracking gift, that. Plus £100 spending money, brilliant. What else is it to talk about? Oh, the meet-up down south with Funky Prepper and Armoured Cockroach and a few of the others are having a meet-up at some farm. Look forward to watching your videos, everyone. As I say, if it can introduce more people to the outdoors, all for it. Absolutely all for it. As I say, I'm looking forward to watching all your videos. And what a good idea, you two. So keep it up. Cracking idea. And if people can, who are new and can come along and spend a couple of days with more experienced people, perfect. Not wrong with that. That is, it's a damn good idea, you two. Brilliant. So as I say, I look forward to your videos and just pretty I couldn't make it really. If I weren't so far away, I would have liked to have gone on that one. So as I say, keep your videos coming and I'll try and watch them all. So and enjoy yourselves, whoever goes, just enjoy yourselves. Don't matter about your skill level, it really doesn't. Just there's plenty of people there that'll help you out if you're struggling. Just go and enjoy, even if you don't learn anything, just being outside will do you the world of good. So So well done, Funky and Armoured Cockroach, for setting that up, and I wish you all your best on you on the camp, and I hope it's a roaring success. What else? Is he out else? I don't think so. I'd like to thank Shane Coffee again for my Moosa cut pot. I'll say that's perfect addition for that. So thanks for that, Shane, and for the water filter. So, you know, I've not used it yet, but I will use it. And I love watching your videos when you take your son out. Superb. You can't beat getting the kids involved, can you? So that's about it for tonight. I'm gonna get off now and wish everyone all the best, and probably do a bit more videoing tomorrow when I get back. Try and get some with the camp president, Mr. Fox, 51 Foxy on, and all the best to Stony Brook again for winning that tremendous prize. Okay, I'll bring you back tomorrow. Bye for now. Here he is, everyone. There's a president. The man who's cat camp. Making a cusker.
All going here, not in a bloody minute.
Not done tea, he's made a cusker.
I know, I'll have a drink after it in a bit. Well, about another 4 days, 5 days.
And I've just cut the Cerrito sausage. So we're cooking outdoors. It's absolutely gorgeous night. Well, afternoon, come night. So Cerrito, there the onions. We have Cerrito rice, some potatoes, sweet corn, and we're going to make some spicy gravy. So we'll bring you back in a bit. Bye now. Okay, everyone. So we're on Cerrito. The onions are in now. Put black pepper, garlic. I'm just going to put some chilli flakes in there. These are a good little thing. These little Nalgene bottles. You get 4 in one of them pouches, some chilli flakes. Smells gorgeous. We'll have to call this video either a lonely camp, because he's had a kite on.
Lonely camp.
Or rain and tears. Gotta go back home again.
I ain't got to do, but I'm gonna do.
Gotta be in his body, so.
Yeah.
So there's no farting on this video.
No, not yet.
President's gone home. Rain stop play.
No trumping yet, have you?
No trumping on the video. That's cooked perfect, that. And get the pan ready for the rice. So I'll bring you back in a bit, everyone. Gorgeous night, beautiful. A bit different when you can just stay outside, eh? Do the cooking,
beautiful, isn't it?
Paul.
Yeah, isn't it? It's brilliant. Can't brilliant. Beat it, can you?
Yeah, so.
Can't beat it.
See you in a bit, everyone. There he is, look, stropping his knife.
Oh, he's got a strop on me.
Oh, he's had a friggy strop on the last couple of days.
Rubbish, isn't it?
Not been out, I've been on my own, lonesome. Are you lonesome tonight? Been singing to myself.
Can't get a pass. Well, I can. could have come if I wanted to, but I can't go into detail.
Oh no.
Can't go into detail.
But how many questions you get answered on that?
Right.
So part timer there.
Yeah.
He's having tea and then he's going to shoot off.
No, not yet. Not until later on.
Later on. All right. See you in a bit. I'll bring you back when I'm on my own.
But I will.
Hey, everyone. So it's just getting ready for bed. Last bit of videoing just to say bye to Raz. And it's been another good 3 nights at Camp Bazza. 3 nights on my own. Never done 3 nights here on my own before. So, next meet up with all the lads is April 11th. Fair few, about 8 of us coming down. So, that's the next meet up. I'm just chilling. Go turn everything out in a bit, get my head down. What will be up early in the morning? Get back home. I've got a funeral to attend tomorrow. Unbelievable. Another young lady's passed away. Anyway, beside the point now. So, yep. So, good news on Andy winning the... Good on you, Andy. Winning the bushcraft ticket, £100 spending money. Tell you the truth, everyone. Andy wasn't going to attend the bushcraft show. He was just going to come up for the day and give his staffs that he's made out. I spoke to him on the phone earlier and he said he didn't tell anyone at Camp Bazza because he didn't want for one of us to say, oh, we'll sort you out, or whatever, you know. He's a proud, proud man. And anyway, he's going. So well done, Andy. He's going. And so that was a good cracking idea, that lad who put the competition up. A bushcraft ticket and £100 spending money. And I don't think there'll be anyone in this community who'll begrudge Andy. I couldn't have thought of a nicer person to win that prize. I don't know who entered it. I didn't enter it myself. But I know the winner, Stonybrook Bushcraft, he's one delighted fella to have won it. So thank you for the person who put the competition up. So anyway, I'm going to get my head down now. Early start tomorrow. So this has been 3 nights at Camp Bazza on my own. I've enjoyed it, actually. I've enjoyed it in the old Arctic tent. So, okay, everyone. See you on the next one. Bye. It's coming down now, the rain. Just lit the old hurricane lamp. Yeah, she's coming down now. Sounds gorgeous, isn't it? sounds lovely. So, what a sound, beautiful. It's about 5 a.m, just having my brew. Can't beat it, rain on canvas. Just can't beat it. That is coming down now. Okay, bring you back tonight probably after I get back. Bit of tea on. I say Paul will be here then, so we'll get some video with Paul. Not featured a lot on this one, has I? Okay then, everyone. I just wanted you to hear the rain, really. Lovely, isn't it? Little simple pleasure in life. All right, bye.
Just want to mention, when you first get these big canvas tents, you do leak on the seams, and what it is that the seams have got a swell and shrink, swell and shrink. I say this used to have drips galore when we first got it, and then after they obviously swell and shrink a few times, they seal themselves up. Now this doesn't get a drip anywhere, so I just thought I'd mention that. This is beautiful, can't beat this. This is called chilling in comfort, listening to the sound of rain on the canvas. And got our brew. All to hand. Actually looking forward to getting back under the tarp. Last time we was here we put Stokey Joe's tarp up. Little fire underneath. Nice. I think I'll call this camp as a video. Rain and tears at Camp Bazza. Yeah, I got upset at the first part of the video, but I'm fine now. It's out of my system. I'll have days like that, I know, but just I don't know what set me off. When I say I was in a pub, all the lads took me out for my birthday. And just went. Well, what it was, must have been a song or something, or... But I say I'm fine now, it's... sat. I'm not fine, but you know, you've still got your own life to live. You know, it's too easy to give up and hit the booze or whatever. Trying not to go down that route, very, very hard trail. So, God, this will be one boring video for you lot to watch. If anyone watches this all the way through, God, they need a medal. I just wanted you to hear the rain. All right, that's enough. I'll, Hello everyone, morning. And all packed up now. Just doing this last little bit of video and then I'm off. Get back home. Just finished my brew. Yeah, it's been quite different without Paul at night. Farting and giggling and just like old school kids, aren't we? That beat it. The Facebook thing's going well. The Camp Bazza Facebook, I think it's about 80 odd members now, which is good. People can put the comments on, and if you've got any ideas, yeah, put them on, get them on. That's what this YouTube and Facebook and the internet is about. It's about sharing ideas and learning off each other, making friendships, and oh, some of the best friends in my life I've met through through YouTube. You know, and the people it's helped, well, I definitely know it's helped my mate Stony Broke. The difference in that bloke in the last 12 months has been a real inspiration. And you know, you can't believe you put up a video. As I say, I always started YouTube, so my grandkids have got something to look back at when I'm long and gone. At what the granddad used to enjoy doing, and that was the only reason. And then through that, it's grew and grew, and you know, it's brilliant, absolutely brilliant. Like I say, some of the best friendships, and it's not just in one country; it's worldwide as well. I talk regular to a lad in Australia. I talk to a lady in Alabama, America. Maria, hi Maria. You know, and it's absolutely superb, brilliant. You know, I can't. I think it's a perfect tool for learning, and absolutely superb for getting ideas of anything. So yeah, keep it going. Let's hope we don't mess about with it too much. And end up messing it all up, because as it is now, it's running just nice and smooth, and it's perfect. So have this brew, get back, and everyone will be back here on the 11th. Old Effie Junior's coming over, so might be the Sunday before I can get up, because it's my daughter's birthday on the Saturday the 12th. So I don't think I can miss that one. So I'll probably come over Sunday, the 11th. So, okay everyone, I'm gonna say my goodbyes until the next video. See ya. Bravo Outdoors, Camp Bazza. Bye now.